It's alleged that Moses Okello, a resident of Alebere village, Bala Seb County, in Kore District, had a misunderstanding with his wife, Sandra Atoro, a mother of the seven-month-old baby. Okello reportedly picked up the child that was lying on the bed, held her up by the legs, then hit her head on the floor. The man reportedly buried the dead body in the rice husk at Okole Swamp, about 2 kilometers from his home. The suspect was arrested together with his brothers and taken to Kore Central Police Station. Relatives of the woman stormed the village and burnt down the suspect's home and that of their mother. They did not find anyone in the home as they had all fled for fear of their lives. My husband got up from bed at 10 a.m. and went to his mother's place to drink. He came home at 2 p.m. and slept. Before he got up to go to where he buys the produce, he returned home at 8 p.m. I gave him water to bathe and then food. But because he was drunk, we had an argument. He grabbed the child and threw her down violently, hitting the head on the ground. I dashed out. I made an alarm. His mother responded and we entered the house, but we did not see the child. Then I called the defense secretary, but he became violent and the defense went to call help. When they came, he was not in the house. My daughter had this child with another man, but Okello insisted that he would take care of the mother and her child. They've spent 3 months together. The seven-month-old baby who was killed was called Jessica Akite. This is indeed absurd. But the suspect, Moses Okello, has been arrested and is in police custody. However, we condemn the acts of those who went to the village and burnt down the houses. Clan members of the suspect and the deceased met at Kore CPS to sort out post-mortem fees and burial expenses. The leaders of Bako Ogwetiang clan gave 300,000 shillings to Okarowok Ata to facilitate post-mortem before they can meet again next week to settle the burial expenses and later blood compensation. We condemn the brutal murder. We are not happy about it. Equally, in another way, some people did not want peace, went and committed a counter crime. They burnt houses, destroyed permanent property, and they've also wanted to kill in revenge. My humble request, such revenge should not continue. If a person commits a crime, let's allow the law to take its course.
That I think people have grown up with here is the culture of revenge, which actually is not the right way to sort out matters. Our approach as an institution of law enforcement is to see that when an incident of any nature happens, it is reported to the authorities and it is investigated to its conclusion. Sometimes, if it is reported to us of a looming danger, we involve the local leadership and the police to sensitize the people and diffuse the tension.
Hudson Apunyu for the news.